Leia here from leiaprosci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we're going to look at different types of chemical reactions.
You'll see many different types of chemical reactions on the MCAT, and even though you won't be tested for them directly, you still want to know what the reaction is and how to recognize them, because this will help you determine how to think about them in terms of balancing and calculations. We briefly mentioned them in the redox video, but let's break them down in more detail. In a disproportionation reaction, we have one molecule or one reactant that forms two different things, where in this case, the H2O2 liquid is going to form both H2O liquid and O2 gas. H2O liquid and O2 gas are two different things, so they're disproportionate. How do we recognize them? If you see a reaction where you have only one reactant, and then you have two different products made up of the same atoms, that's how you recognize that it's a disproportionation reaction. I like to think of a single replacement reaction as a single swap reaction. For example, here we have chlorine gas reacting with two potassium bromides. Chlorine is by itself, potassium and bromide are ionically bound. In the products, chlorine, which was by itself, is now part of the ionic compound, and bromine, which was ionic, is now by itself. So what did we swap? Well, the potassium swapped partners. It had a bromine in the reactant and a chlorine in the product. The way you recognize a single replacement reaction is identifying that something by itself is no longer by itself. Same thing here. Something by itself didn't used to be by itself. This is very similar to the double replacement reaction, but where the single replacement was one swap, the double replacement is a two swap reaction, meaning each reactant is going to swap partners. This is what we saw in the precipitation reaction. The way to recognize a double replacement is to recognize that each group swapped partners. In the reactants, calcium is partnered with chlorine. In the products, it's partnered with carbonate. In the reactants, potassium is partnered with carbonate, but in the products, partnered with chlorine. The double replacement is also called a metathesis reaction. A combination or synthesis reaction, exactly as the name implies, is when two things combine or that we synthesize, make something from smaller pieces. For example, in this reaction, where 2H2 gas reacts with oxygen gas to form 2H2O liquid. The way to recognize this is that the reaction has one product formed from two different reactants. The two different reactants had to combine to form that one product. This is the exact opposite of the decomposition reaction, which is the reaction in which something breaks apart. Notice that 2H2O breaking apart to give us 2H2 gas plus O2 gas is the exact opposite of the combination reaction. It's just the reverse reaction. And the way to recognize that is to see that we have one reactant that breaks apart to give us two different products. Now, if you're looking at this and thinking, how is this different from the disproportionation reaction, where we had one reactant also give us two different products? The difference here is that in decomposition, the one reactant breaks up. It's not that one atom becomes two different types of products. It's that it breaks apart so that the atoms separate. In the decomposition of H2O, the hydrogen breaks apart from the oxygen so that the products give us hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. In the disproportionation reaction of hydrogen peroxide, it's not that we break the hydrogen and oxygen away from each other, but instead they break up unevenly. So the oxygen winds up in two of the products. It winds up as a single oxygen in water and a diatomic molecule, meaning an O2 gas, as another oxygen product. And last but not least, we have combustion, which is a rapid exothermic oxidation reaction, typically burning a carbon source in the presence of oxygen. So think of it as a burning reaction, like a gas stove or a campfire. You'll recognize a combustion reaction when you see some number of carbon and hydrogen, and maybe even oxygen, reacting with O2 gas, that's the key to combustion, to give us carbon dioxide and water. In the first reaction, we're just showing carbon and hydrogen. Methane reacts with oxygen to give carbon dioxide and water. But you can also have larger molecules, like this reaction here. In fact, you need to recognize this reaction for the MCAT. C6H12O6 is a monosaccharide, for example glucose, can be burned in the presence of 6 oxygen to give us 6 carbon dioxide and 6 water. If we burn it, it's combustion, but you probably recognize this from metabolism which happens in the body, and that is not a combustion reaction because it's probably not a good idea to light a fire inside your cells. But that's a topic for another video. For now, given that we understand the different types of reactions, let's look at how to balance them, but not just the right way to do it, but the fast way to do it, because on the MCAT, you don't have the time for tedious balancing of equations. First, if you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, then click the subscribe button and bell icon so that you don't miss any of the new videos. Then visit my website, layerforsci.com/reactions, for the complete stoichiometry video series along with the practice quiz and cheat sheet. The link again is layerforsci.com/reactions.